Hey guys, welcome back to
another dose. You want to do my intro?
Yeah. What's up guys, KharmaMedic here and welcome back to another dose.
You nailed it. Hey guys, so Alexia is visiting in London, which has been really, really nice. I feel like I've taken a bit of a step back from being super hardworking and managing my time as much as possible every single minute of the day. We've been going out quite a bit, walking around and enjoying.
But always safety with masks.
Always safety with masks.
Distancing.
Yeah, of course, as everyone should be during this time. So I'm actually moving out of London to a city about an hour and a half away for my next clinical placement. I'm going to be starting mental health. We're going to be living in a shared flat, which I haven't done in a long time. There's gonna be 8 of us to a flat, shared bathroom, shared kitchen. So that'll be interesting to see as well. I'm gonna take a lot of my cooking stuff, all my camera gear and things like that as well, so I can keep you guys involved and show you how it goes. Tomorrow, I've actually got my first progress test of my 4th year of medical school.
All right, gonna start. Wish me luck.
So yeah, today, Alexia and I are just walking around in the parks and in some nice areas that we were in before around Paddington and Bayswater. It's really good to take a break whenever you can. Isn't that right, Lexi? Got a second one in the mix. Go, 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 go! It's a bit too harsh. Walking around this park in the inner city areas that we were walking in before really makes me feel like I haven't explored London enough. I've been here for 3 years, but I always go to like the same places or the most common places, the most well-known places, and I feel like there's still so much for me to explore, so much to see. I have plenty of time over the next couple of years, but I just need to make a more conscious effort to get out and about, explore these different areas. Alexia has found these two little trees. They are really nice. Open sesame. All alone on the underground, this is a rarity. We got tired of walking, so we're gonna take the tube to Soho, where we're gonna eat bao buns. I've actually never had a bao bun. Alexia says they taste really good, so we're gonna go try them out. Isn't that right, Lex?
Yeah.
Soho, and you won't believe who was sitting right behind us over there, who's now gone. It is Daisy Edgar Jones, otherwise known as Marianne from Normal People. And Alexia and I were both completely starstruck, and thankfully Alexia worked up the courage to go and say hi to her, just say we really like your show, we're obsessed with it, we have one episode left, blah blah blah. I was definitely too nervous to go say hi, and she seemed really nice, really sweet.
Yeah.
Very down to earth. It was really cool to meet her. We've ordered these like teas, quite good, and waiting on our bao buns. Show you when we get them. Okay. All right, Lexi, name your top 3 bao buns.
I only had 2, so honestly, the best one was for sure the fried chicken.
Same, I completely agree.
Strongly recommend.
I also had the lamb one, which was quite good. If you guys come to Bao Soho, you should check them out.
Oh, wait, what?
Oh, alright guys, so all done with lunch now. We just went to Whole Foods, got a couple of snacks so we can have them at home and enjoy over the next couple of hours. And right now we're in Piccadilly Circus, which you guys might have seen if you've come to London. It's been a long, long day of walking around. Gonna head home, do a little bit of work, do my last amount of preparation for tomorrow's exam. And then yeah, wake up tomorrow nice and early and get writing. Hey guys, back home now. We've just been sitting down on our phones, chilling for a little bit. I've gotten really, really tired from that long walk that we did today. Like I mentioned before, I have my first progress test of the year tomorrow at 10 a.m. So I've just sat down now for a little bit. I'm gonna go through a couple of past medicine questions on the computer and take notes down here on my iPad. as I always do when studying for my exams. Since this test is a progress test, I'm going to be tested on material that I won't have studied yet that will be covered in the future throughout years 4 and then 5. So I'm not really too concerned about doing very well because I haven't studied the vast majority of the material. It's just sort of a good test to see where you are, how much you already know, and what you need to focus on moving forward. I'm just going to bang out a couple of questions for a bit. I think I'll leave you guys over here if the camera sits, which it does. Fantastic. All right, just finished my first ever online medical school exam. I think it went well, it wasn't bad at all. It was just a bit strange to do one online instead of a big exam hall. But now Alexia and I have come to the local high street in order to get some lunch. We're going to this place called Good Life Eatery. It has like these salmon quinoa bowls and stuff like that, which we quite like and is probably Alexia's favorite.
Okay, so wait, before we order.
Heading home now, but very interestingly, while we were at that,
it's like the little head just bobbing up and down.
You fit in frame though.
A bit,
barely. As we were leaving that store, Lex was getting her matcha latte. One of you guys recognized me, came up to me to say hi, which was a really, really great experience. Almost every day that Alexia and I have been out this week, one of you has recognized me and come to say hi, which is absolutely crazy to think about. It's so strange that people would recognize me on the street and want to take a photo with me or anything like that. But yeah, if you guys do see me in public, please do feel free to come say hi. I love talking to you, I love meeting you. It would be a pleasure. All right, heading home now. I'm gonna do a little bit of work and then see what we do.
No work. No work.
What do you
want to
do?
Only fun things.
Like what?
I don't know. Fun stuff. Film.
We finished Normal People. A really good show. Did I? Oh yeah, I told you guys, we met Marianne. I thought I hadn't told you for a second. All right guys, back home now, and look at what arrived. Very, very excitingly, my new lens, f1.8, 20mm, which is gonna be great to like completely blur out my background and keep me in tack sharp focus. We've got shutter speed 1 over 50, f1.8, ISO 100, and I think we are good to go. This is all in an effort to make my vlogging setup on the A7 S3 as small, lightweight, and compact as possible. And that's Alexia's vlogging camera, and now we have a whole shelf of cameras, pretty crazy. All right, so Lex and I are gonna chill a little bit. I'm going to look at this Sony lens and enjoy myself with my new tech. And yeah, catch you guys in a bit. Peace.
No,
I'm not
kidding.
But yeah.
wait. Is that why I turned into my iPhone store today?
No.
Actually, are you sure you can open it?
Yeah. It's yours behind it.
I'm so excited. Oh my god. So pretty.
I know, right?
Oh my god. I'm actually shook.
I think there's also a pull tab there.
Should I stop?
Yeah.
Good morning guys, it is Sunday and today is the day. I am moving an hour and a half outside of London to my new medical placement. So I have got a bunch of packing to do. I've currently got an empty suitcase and I feel like this is going to be a bit of a difficult packing job because I need to take clothes, I need to take cooking equipment, all the small things that I might need here and there. I've got a bunch of camera gear as well. I need to decide what I'm going to take, all of this vlogging equipment, tripods and things like that. So I feel like I do have quite a bit of things to think about. I'm also deadly scared that I'm going to forget a charger or like a piece of equipment that I really want and then I'm going to be there and need it and not have it. So I'm going to just look around my entire room like piece by piece and tell myself, do I need that? Do I need that? Do I need that? Do I need that? Etc. I'm gonna set you guys up over here and then you can watch me run around and pack like a madman because my friend Rachel from medical school is coming to pick me up at 5 p.m. So I've got a couple of hours to get everything ready. Say my last goodbyes to Alexia before I disappear as well. Anyways, gonna get started packing and I'll talk to you soon. Alright guys, I am pretty much done packing the suitcase. Please ignore how messy that shirt is folded there. I've got my shoes, running shoes, clinical shoes, got my shirts, everything that I need for exercise, going to the gym, pajamas, got plenty of t-shirts, hoodies, jackets, etc. I think I'm gonna be good. Now as far as electronics goes, well, minus Alexia straightening her hair, I think I've decided that I'm only gonna take this small vlogging camera, at least for now. I really do want to take my big camera with the new lens and the new microphone setup that I have, but I'm not gonna take it at the moment because it's just the beginning. I wanna go and settle in before I actually take some big heavy camera gear. Since now I'm going for a couple of days and then coming back to London, I just wanna take sort of the majority of things that I'm gonna leave there. And then once I check out the vibe, see what it's like, you know, how much space I actually have, how much I can film and things like that, I'll decide how many more things I wanna take.
Sounds good.
Ooh, almost forgot. Now, the next thing that I need to do is figure out what I'm going to take with regards to cooking equipment. Because as you guys know, I cook the vast majority of my meals and I want to continue to do that when I'm there. So now I'm in the kitchen and I don't know how I'm going to do this. I do need to take like a pot, a pan, plate, cutlery. I need stuff for coffee, tea, food. I'll buy food from there, but I need to take a couple of like key essential cooking utensils and tools so I can actually make food when I'm there. So let me go get my tripod. All right, so I have been at it in the kitchen for a little bit and I've decided on quite a few things that I want to take with me. I've got here some protein powder for after my runs, double bags so it doesn't pop, one pan. I've got my much needed olive oil so I can cook my eggs in the morning, salt, pepper, this mocha pot. I think it's going to be easier to take this and make coffee rather than taking my French press because I feel like that requires a lot of maintenance and cleaning every day. Got two bowls, two pieces of olive oil, I need a couple of utensils in food, two small plates, one big plate, my hand is very useful, a bunch of things here, and then I can store it in your fridge. So that's pretty much it. There really isn't that much there. I think this should be good, at least for the beginning, and I'll identify what I need as I go along, and I can always bring it with me later on. All right, so let's put these in a bag. Let's see if I can make it work. I have finished packing. I've got all of my electronics, my kitchen stuff, toiletries, so I'm pretty much good to go. Just need to eat some food. Pop down to the shops to get a couple last minute things. And then get going. So I'll catch up with you guys in a bit. So this is it. My life packed for the next 8 weeks or so. I'm honestly really gonna miss this room. I've spent the last 3 years making it perfect. I know I'm gonna come back every week, but it's gonna feel strange to like move to a completely different physical location. I was telling Alexia earlier that I kind of feel like I'm going to my first day of university, like driving up there with my bags packed and everything, gonna meet new people and settle in a new apartment. Gonna be a good experience, I think. Change is always good, and it'll be a way to branch out and see medicine in a different area than strictly central London. All right, guys, time has come on our merry way. Going down to meet Rachel in the car. See you in her.
Bye. I feel like I'm going too. No, no, I'm good.
Yeah. How do you find driving, man? All right, so we just made it to the hospital. The drive wasn't too bad at all. We got our set of keys from the hospital. Now we're gonna be heading to the accommodation. It'll be pretty exciting. I'll show you guys what it's like once we get there. And yeah, moving in.
I'm just moving in.
Oh, I love it.
The door is open.
That was easy.
That was so easy.
All right, so I've just walked into my room. And first impressions are, this is all right. It's kind of small. An L-shaped desk over here with some drawers and a chair. What looks like a very uncomfortable bed, but I'll let you know after I've slept on it once. A chair here, a sink with a mirror in my room. This is a first for me, but we'll see how it goes. And then what is closet space over here so I can hang up my shirts and things like that. I think I'm gonna end the vlog over here. I'm just gonna unpack and like make this room a little bit more of my own, put everything in its place and organize and neatify everything, put all my food in the kitchen, things like that. And then yeah, try and find out where everyone is, go and hang out with them and relax for the night. Stay tuned for the future videos about my experiences living in this room, going to the hospital in this area and everything like that. So I hope you guys have enjoyed the video. Hope you've enjoyed this vlog. If you did, don't forget to leave a like on it and subscribe to my channel to see more content from me in the future. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace. All right, so I'm just unpacking all of my food into my designated closet, and I come across this. That is all mold inside of the bread packets.
That is absolutely disgusting.